Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to print the odd numbers by using for loop in Java using two ways. So let's get started. So first we'll be getting the number n from the user, which is going to be the term till which we will be printing the odd numbers. So for this we need to import the scanner class. So it's going to be import java.util. We'll be having the scanner class, and inside the main function it's going to be scanner input equal to new scanner, and it's going to be system dot in over here. And the next line, let's have a variable int n equal to input dot next int. So you need to use next int, don't use next line or something else, because this is going to be of type integer. And above that, let's just have a print statement saying, just go here, system.outprint, enter a number, something like this. Yeah, this is good. And let's just have our for loop. So in the first way, I won't be showing you to use a if condition. I will just go with the plain for loop. So it's going to be for int I equal to 1. So this is going to be our initial value that gets printed. So have it as 1, don't have it as 0 or 2, because 0 is a neutral number and 2 is an even number. So just have I equal to 1. And the condition is going to be I less than or equal to n and I plus plus. So first let me just show you the normal way, and later I will show you how to improvise your code so that it prints the odd numbers alone. So just have here system.out.print new line, I'll just print I. Alright, so this is nothing much, this is just a basic for loop that prints from 1 till our number n. So let me just now show you how we can change this code. Okay, let me just now check whether if it's running or not. Running it, and let the number, let me go with 10 over here. So I'm getting numbers from 1 to 10. So what is happening here is that our increment value is I plus plus. So for each time the for loop is going to run, our I value gets incremented only once. So for example, during the first iteration, I gets printed, that is 1 is getting printed, and after that it goes here I plus plus, which basically this is the same, I equal to I plus 1. This is what happens for each iteration. So after 1 gets printed, I equal to 1 plus 1, 2, 2 gets printed, and after that it goes here I equal to 2 plus 1, 3 gets printed, and I equal to 3 plus 1, 4 gets printed, and this goes on till this. So to avoid printing all the numbers, what we can do is, rather than having the condition as I equal to I plus 1, which is I plus plus, this both are exactly the same, okay, and rather than having this way, we can just have I equal to I plus 2. So I'll just show you this first, like I'll just show you first, these things are the same. I'm just saving it, and let me just rerun it again. Just go with 10. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting the same thing. So rather than having this way, what we can do is we can have I equal to I plus 2. Okay, yeah, that's it. So now what happens here is that initially what will happen is that 1 will be getting printed. Just imagine this is the output. 1 will be getting printed and will come to the increment I equal to 1 plus 2. Next, 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 will be getting printed. It goes here I equal to I plus 2, which is 3. 3 plus 2 is 5, it goes here and I equal to 5 plus 2, which is 7, 7 gets printed, goes again there, I equal to 7 plus 2, 9, and it goes on till your number n. So through this way, we will be only getting the odd numbers. So really simple way, let me just now save it and clear it all, and let me just now run it. I will go with 10, same 10. So here you can see I'm getting the numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Simple. So this is the first way. I think this is the simplest way. So that's why I mentioned it first. And the second way is going to be the similar way, but here we'll be having a condition. So let me just live with the default I plus plus. So what I will do here is that I will just have a condition saying if, and enclose the print statement within that if condition. So what I will do here is that if I modulus of 2 equality 1. So when we perform modulus operation to a even number by 2, we will be getting the remainder as 0, because this modulus operator basically gives us a remainder. So just imagine we are having some even numbers 10, 6, 8, and just imagine doing modulus with 2. We are going to get 0. So this is the logic, guys. So if we perform modulus operator by even numbers by 2, we will be getting the remainder as 0. But in case of odd numbers like 7, 9, 11, we will be getting the remainder as 1. So in case if our remainder is 1 over here, we will be printing the number. And in case if our remainder is 0, we won't be printing this number. I hope that made sense. So just imagine one is coming. At first, 1 will come. 1 modulus of 2 is equal to 1. This condition is true. It prints 1 in the output. And next iteration, 2 will be coming. 2 modulus of 2 is 0, because 2 is perfectly divisible by 2. And the remainder is going to be 0. So 0 equal to 1, condition is false. The print statement doesn't get executed. It goes again, i++. It becomes 3, 3 modulus of 2. 3 is not divisible by 2, so we will be getting the remainder over there, which is 1. 1 equal to 1, we will be getting 3 printed. So this also goes on till our number n. So this is kind of, you know, a secondary way of doing this. I wouldn't recommend this. The first way is much more simpler and much more faster. And let me just now run the same. It's fine. Let me go run it. 10. Here you can see I'm getting 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. So you can choose whichever the way you want. And I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I have done a lot of Java tutorials as well as programming videos in C, C++, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries, as well as CRUD operations by using Spring Boot and Node.js, as well as 3D animation using Blender. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.